Hi friends, have all a wonderful Wednesday evening. Today I finally have the time to show you my little project I did last week, so that I couldn't do lockpicking videos. Did take quite a long time, and I've already shown it to a couple friends, and maybe you can guess what it is when I show you the bottom. It actually is a full 3D printed and 3D designed padlock. I did every bit design from scratch on. It does have double ball V-rings, it does have a plastic shackle. The only metal parts are the shackle spring, the grub screws, and of course the pins. And I even made a key. I made it I think on Monday. It doesn't look that nice, but I think it's okay. You can see it from the front here. I did choose a half decent keyway so that I can work on the pins. The picking is actually very, very hard, and it does work absolutely nice. You can see it makes even a nice sound. Here are the grooves for the ball bearings. I will show you this later in detail when I take it apart. The key is key retaining. Sometimes the plug comes out a little bit because the core retaining pin is a little thin, but I didn't have a longer pin. So okay, let's try to pick it. As I said, not that easy. The feedback from the plastic is not the greatest. They have to be a little bit careful. I think I will set a tensioner on the bottom to save the plastic a little bit here. I hope that works. Let's see, I will use the Attila and my trusty short wiper tensioner here. It's a little bit bright. Maybe we can get the light a little bit to the back. Okay, the pins inside are not that crazy. They were just what I had laying around and what doesn't wear the plastic off too much. Okay, a little click from the middle, one from the front, and the lock core turned a little bit. I'm feeling for some pins. I can already tell you that I have a couple spools inside. Okay, click from, I think this is 4. I'm not 100% sure if I have set it high enough now. 1 is loose, 2, 3. It's very hard to feel. Actually, the pin stacks here. Okay. Okay, another little turn. One was falling down. Okay. Hope it's not too much more work here. Okay. I don't want to destroy the holes because the plastic is not that robust. Okay, let's see. Okay, a little bit feedback from pin 2 here. I have to be quite careful. Okay, one did drop down again. And here it's open. Pretty cool pick. Not too easy, as I said. And now let's take it apart. I will show you all the details. Let me put the key here. I will close it again. The lock is really 100% working, and I've seen a couple padlocks designed on Thingiverse, but they are all different than this one here. There are really only three main pieces beside the little ball bearings. Okay, we have just the parts I had laying around, steel springs, we have here an aluminium pin from an Abus padlock. So, as I said, pins are not crazy. It's all about the plastic parts. And here we have the first spool and two. Oh. And key pins are all standard pins. So another aluminium driver pin here from that Abus. I think it was 64. Not that sure. I have a big bag with pins and stuff. You can see the spring on 4 is different. It's a 5-pin lock. The spring on 4 is different. These were my last springs I had. Okay, almost shoot out the spring here. Yeah. Another copper spring on 5. And another spool driver. I will show you the pins in detail in a second. And the last pin here is the core retaining pin. Okay, not that easy to get it out. The spring is together with the retaining pin here. Because the pin is so slim, I wish I had a thinner pin. And now I can actually get the core out. Okay, also ball bearings did fall out. It is very, very hard to print little round balls on the 2D printer. And you see one is smaller than the other. The bigger one goes to the longer shackle side because it keeps the shackle in, and you will see why. And we have from a pen a spring which goes on the shackle. Okay, let's show bit by bit. Here you can see the shackle. This is a cutout for the ball bearing. This keeps the shackle locked, and here you can see a thin down area, so the shackle can move out when the ball is retracted a little bit. It is not fully retracted because it has to hold the shackle in. So the last bit holds the shackle in. It's hard to see. This cutout is a little bit shallower than the big one here. And it is cut around so that the shackle can spin around. It's different on the right side. We have again a deeper groove here for the ball, but this ball is retracted completely so that the shackle can get out completely on the right side. And you see this accordingly on the plug. Actually pretty cool. Printed, I think I printed this upstanding like this here. That came out very nice. I had only to clean up the hole slightly, and you can see even a little bit warding inside. Maybe when I show my finger behind this. It was relatively hard to design, but it worked out. I had only one other prototype. I will show you this in a second. And you can see the left side, which goes to the longer shackle end, is a little bit shallower, so that the even bigger ball bearing cannot retract completely and holds the shackle in. And here it is deeper. This is the purpose of different size ball bearings and different holes. And the last part is the lock body. I can see 5 pin chambers, and the 6th one is to hold the plug in here, and the rotation of the plug is limited, so it can only open to the right. I could have made it open to both sides when I just had to cut this a little bit more to this side here, no problem, but I decided to go only to one side. And you can see it from the inside. The hard thing to do is to make these cutouts for the ball bearings so that the ball bearings cannot fall out. So they are, I would say, not like drilled to, they are round cuts and hold the ball bearings in. I can probably show you this. So it does not go through, it is held up at a certain position. And this was one of the hardest things to design in, together with making the ball the right size. Now it's somewhere here. Ah, it's here. Okay, and I quickly show you the first prototype. Here the cut was completely around. The drills for the ball bearings were the same. So I made these mistakes the first time, and here my first try to get the shackle hold in, it was just molten plastic. But I learned from that, and also the hole from the ball bearings was going too, and I also learned from that. And the shape might be very familiar to you, because this was the lock I took as a sample. Maybe you can see it here. Not exactly the same, but you might get it. The trusty Abus ATTI. I hope you like this little project. Have fun picking and see you in the next video. Bye. Oh, and of course, I forgot to show you all the parts in a little close-up. You can see the pins here. Can see the key, and I think I've already shown you the plug in detail and also the lock body. And I threaded this, of course. No pre-drilling was needed, and just the I think M4 thread. And here again the shackle in a little close-up. Okay, but this was it now. See you in the next video. Have a great evening. Bye.